This video is about recursively defined sequences of the form x sub n equals a function of x sub n minus 1. So first we have this example of the f of x is a cosine, and your first value is given to be 0. And then from then on, every next x sub n value in a sequence is going to be f of the previous one. So it sort of feeds back into the function and keeps on going like that. And the idea is, do these sequence values converge to a value, or do they not converge? So in this problem, you have the first value is given to be 0. The second value is f of the first one, see, xn minus 1, 1 previous, and then xn 1 was 0, so that plugs in there, but f is cosine. Cosine of 0 is 1, and that's in radian mode. Then to get x sub 3, that's equal to f of the previous x sub 2, according to the formula over here, and that was 1 from here. And it's cosine of 1 is equal to this. But we're going to keep on continuing with this process. And these decimal numbers are, not only are they not completely the whole story because they're rounded off, you don't need to do this because we have this calculator, which we're using anyway to get these values. So instead of typing this cosine of the value 1, we type in cosine of the answer. In other words, the previous answer that we got, we're putting that back into the cosine. And you get this answer syntax here from second ANS, and that's on the little minus key. So then you're going to get something like this. The first one, you put it in. Cosine of 0, that's 1. And then you go cosine of that answer, which is 1. And that gives you this number. And you get a cosine of the answer, which this is the answer. So you get cosine of that, and it's this. And you keep on going like that. And you see if these numbers stabilize anywhere. Well, so somewhere along in that process, you're going to get tired of doing that. Which, you know, yeah, calculator, it's a pretty good method. But if you want a faster method using the calculator, you do this. You set up a sequence in the calculator. So you go to the mode, sequence, then the y equals key, you put in the n minimum. That's not the value, that is the n counter. So that's 1, because we started with x sub 1. Then you put in cosine of u of n minus 1. So u of n is the values in the sequence, and they're created by having cosine of the previous value in the sequence. So where are you going to get these letters? Well, u is on the calculator, and it is obtained by second and on the 7 key. 7. On the 7 key, second 7 gets you that u. The n is the xt theta n key, like if you were going to try to put x somewhere, but it knows you're in the sequence mode, so it puts n. And you subtract 1 in a normal way, finish off with the parentheses, and there's another parentheses over here that wasn't seen on the calculator. And then it asks for the first sequence term. And that was cosine of 0. So 0 is the first one. Actually, this is a 0 that you put here. That's a 0. Okay. I had that on the screen wrong a couple of seconds ago. I corrected that to be 0 goes there. And that's under y equals. And where do you get this u from? Was the second, 7 key, and then you got this n from the x, t, theta, n key. And it shows up as an n because we know we're in sequence mode. Okay, then you go to table setup over here, and you see, I just set it up as 1 when that really doesn't matter though. But what does matter is to set it to ask and auto for dependent. And then you just type in things like 1, and you see that the first term really is x of 1 is 0, x of 2 is the 1, x of 5, 10. You just put in any numbers you want because it's going to ask for them and then tell you what the answer is. And when you get to 1,000, it's 73909, so it already stabilized by that point. Then you back it up and you try 50, and you can see it's getting close around 20. So we think that it's zeroing in on 73909. Okay, so the recursively defined sequence limits to 73909, but actually it's 0.7390851 3, and I'll show you how we got that in a second. So f of L is supposed to be L. So cosine of this number does indeed check out to be this number. So that checks out. Now back to this question, why was it this instead of a 9 there? Because I was curious as to, you know, if there was other digits there. So I put into a regular graphing mode y equals cosine x and y equals x. So what is the x value where cosine x equals x? So you plot those two and do a second calc intersect, and it comes out right here and right here. So that is that's the x value. And then another way to look at this is to plot the values of the sequence against the n's. So these are n's down here, in size, and these are the values, and you can see that the sequence values stabilize and limit out to a certain value, and that was 0.739 something right in there.